Hello everyone, I am Divyarani Pandurang Babar, working as an assistant professor at AISSMS IOIT, Pune. Today we are going to talk about different kinds of logical operators available in propositional logic. So there are five logical operators that we will focus on. First one is negation, second one is conjunction, third one is disjunction, fourth one is implication, fifth one is biconditional. Now, let's talk about first operator available in this list, that is negation operator. Now, see here, let P be a proposition, then negation P or not P is called negation of P, which simply states that it is not the case that P. First of all, please note that this is a symbol used to represent the negation. So, if P is true, then negation P is false. If P is false, then negation P is true. Let's consider one example. Let P be a proposition. Adam and Eve lived together for many years. Then negation P will be, it is not the case that Adam and Eve lived together for many years. As I have already told you that what a negation really means, when we try to negate particular proposition that is represented by P, we simply state that it is not the case that P. Here also we negotiate particular proposition Adam and Eve lived together for many years. And result of negation would be, it is not the case that Adam and Eve lived together for many years. Or for the sake of simplicity, we can simply write like this way as well. Adam and Eve haven't lived together for many years. It is not always necessary that you should place it is not the case that in front of the proposition. You can write something else that goes with the meaning. For the sake of reference, I am providing truth table of negation of P. See the truth table here. If P is true, then negation P is false. If P is false, then negation P is true. Now, next logical operator is conjunction. Let P and Q be two propositions. Conjunction of P and Q is denoted by P and Q. Please note that this is a symbol used to represent the conjunction between two propositions. When both P and Q are true, then only the compound proposition, that is P and Q, is true. Now consider one example. 12 is divisible by 3 and 3 is a prime number. Now we know that 12 is divisible by 3. This is correct one, and 3 is a prime number. This is also correct one. So true and true, answer will be true, because when both P and Q are true, then compound proposition, that is P and Q, is true. Please note one important point. Sometimes we use but instead of and. For example, 12 is divisible by 3, but 3 is a prime number. Now, for the sake of reference, I am providing truth table for P and Q. Now, see the truth table here. When P is true, Q is true, P and Q is true. When P is true, Q is false, P and Q is false. When P is false, Q is true, P and Q is false. When P is false, Q is false, then P and Q is false. That means when both P and Q are true, then only compound proposition P and Q is true. Now, next logical operator is disjunction. Let P and Q be propositions. Disjunctions of P and Q is denoted by P or Q. See the symbol here. The symbol is used to represent the disjunctions. When both P and Q are false, then only the compound proposition P or Q is false. Consider one example. 16 minus 4 is equal to 10, or 4 is an even number. Now see here, 16 minus 4 is equal to 10. This proposition is false. Or 4 is an even number. 4 is an even number. This is true. So false or true will be true, because when both P and Q are false, then only the compound proposition P or Q is false. Now, for the sake of reference, see the truth table here. When P is true, Q is true, then P or Q is true. When P is true, Q is false, then P or Q is true. When P is false, Q is true, P or Q is true. When P is false, Q is false, then P or Q is false. When both P and Q are false, then only compound proposition P or Q is false. Now, next logical operator is implication. Consider two propositions P and Q. The propositions if P then Q denoted by P implies Q. See here, this is the symbol which is used to represent implication. It is also called as conditional statement. Now, in this statement, P is called as hypothesis or premise, and Q is called as conclusion or consequence. Let us see the truth table for implication. If P is true, Q is true, then P implies Q is true. If P is true, Q is false, then P implies Q is false. If P is false, Q is true, then P implies Q is true. If P is false, Q is false, then P implies Q is true. When P is true and Q is false, then P implies Q is false. Now, consider one example. If you try hard for your exam, then you will succeed. Now, here are the two propositions. So P is equal to you tried hard for your exam, and Q is equal to you succeed. Now let's consider four cases here. Now consider case number one. You tried hard for your exam and you succeed. Now see here, you tried hard for your exam. This statement is true. And you succeed. It is also true. Then P implies Q is true. Now consider the case number 2. You tried hard for your exam but you failed. You tried hard for your exam is true. You failed is false. Then P implies Q is false. Now consider case number 3. You haven't tried hard for your exam and you succeed. Now you haven't tried hard for your exam is false and you succeed is true. Then P implies Q is true. Now consider case number 4. That is, you haven't tried hard for your exam and you failed. Now see here, you haven't tried hard for your exam is false and you failed is also false. Then compound proposition P implies Q is true. Now one more logical operator is there, that is biconditional. Now see, a biconditional statement is a combination of a conditional statement and its converse written in the if and only if form. So, a biconditional is true if and only if both the conditions are true. Now, this is the symbol used to represent biconditional statement. For the sake of reference, see the truth table for biconditional statement. When P is true, Q is true. P biconditional, Q is true. If P is true, Q is false. P biconditional, Q is false. If P is false, Q is true. P biconditional, Q is false. If P is false, Q is false. P biconditional, Q is true. That means a biconditional is true if and only if both the conditions are true. This is all about the logical operators. Thank you.